hear your names. Mr. Brown, Mr. White, Mr. Blonde, Mr. Blue, Mr. Orange, Mr. Pink.
Why am I Mr. Pink?
Because you're a faggot, all right?
All right, what movie does this remind you of instantly? Come on. You know what? You know the movie, right? I know most of you know the even the broads will get it. Come on, you know this? I'll wait for the breakdown. I'll wait for the breakdown of it. Where the hell is it? Where the hell is it? I had this whole fucking thing queued up. This part right here, you don't remember this? I even did the sound effects. Remember that? Reservoir Dogs, when he cuts the fucking dude's ear off.
Hey, what's going on? You hear that?
I used to love that goddamn song, and I couldn't listen to it for 10 years because every time I fucking heard it, I just thought about Marvin Nash getting his goddamn ear cut off. Stop! Stop!
Stop!
What?
Don't.
What's the matter?
Don't do this! Please!
That burn a little bit?
Just right, stop! Stop! Please! Stop! Just stop! 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 Just talk to me for a minute! Don't! Please! Don't burn me! Please!
I'm yelling at him. Fucking, what a great piece of acting by both of those guys. Whoever played Marvin Nash and Mr. Blonde. I can never remember people's fucking names. We'll call him Vince Gilligan. I don't know his fucking name. How the fuck did I forget his name? You know, most guys to play a psycho would act like a fucking psycho, how they think a psycho's supposed to act. You know? And just how fucking calm he was. You know? That's what's really fucking scary. Somebody cutting your ear off going, and acting like a fucking maniac. You'd almost start laughing halfway through it. Like, is this guy mocking being crazy? But it's the calmness with which he does it. Here's another one for you. These are really easy for, like, guy movies. So I need some more suggestions. I'm actually going to disguise this one. I downloaded this song because of the movie. And I didn't realize that this fucking Irish dude babbles telling some fucking story for 20 minutes before they get to the part that I actually recognized. Let's see if you can guess this one. Here we go. What movie?
Though gods they were, and as the elders of our time choose to remain blind, let us rejoice and let us sing.
All right, you're like, what the fuck is this? I didn't want to get blood on the floor. Come on, you know it. Below the ocean. That's Donovan singing Atlantis. That was from the Billy Bat scene. When they start kicking the shit out of fucking Billy Bats. Is there anything better than that fucking camera angle? When they're pointing up at Robert De Niro's character, Jimmy, just fucking kicking him. Ric Flair couldn't do fake kicks better than Robert De Niro, you know? He's just sitting there kicking him. See, this was bad. Billy Bats was a made guy with some real greaseball shit. We did what we wanted. We were wise guys, right?
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to host The Tonight Show. There was Stevie the Sidekick.
Hey, how's it going? Bada bing, gabba goo.
And there was the Roots crew led by Johnny Drumsticks.
Sup, man?
There was hashtag the Dancing Panda. And Stepdad Gary.
His daughter Lainey's pretty good.
And of course, Sarah No H, who got that nickname because she thought H's were...
I got places to go and I got people to see. If anyone asks, say you ain't seen me. I'm wanted, just means I'm high in demand.
What's up, Pigs?
But you
Pigtown Entertainment originates.